Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy to Q. And during a live stream, someone asked, hey, how do you exclude the top N rows from a table? And I'm making some assumptions here that they're using employees, products, or subcategories of products, or categories of products, who knows, right? And how do I exclude the ones that have the most sales, that have the highest GPAs, that has the most hours worked? How do I exclude those so I can focus on the products or the subcategories or the categories that's not selling as much, that's not working as much from a table visual in Power BI? Well, you got to use DAX, or at least I'm going to use DAX in my solution. And so instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. So I have a model. I'm using AdventureWorks, and I'm going to use subcategories. This is a small list and it's easier to visualize. So I'm using the subcategory column from a product table that I've created. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to add total sales amount to it. And then we're going to sort it. And we want to exclude these top three because they're big sellers. These subcategories are selling a lot. And then we want to focus on these. So I'm going to go over to the DAX query view, my new favorite feature. Model view used to be my favorite feature, and it's still one of my favorite features, but this new DAX query view has got me all excited. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to see how many subcategories I have. So we're going to run this. Let me see, we have 38. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another query right here, and I'm going to try to find out which subcategories are at the top. So I'm going to define a variable, and let's do this like a cooking show instead of me typing all this. As you can see, I'm in a variable. I'm going to tuck the top three subcategories based on sales amount, and then I'm going to write an evaluate statement that is going to give me a list of those and find only the three that's in that list. Okay, so let's run this. Now, I could have done this another way, so let me show you. I'm going to add another evaluate down here. Evaluate, and I could have just evaluated the variable because it actually returns a table. So I'll run this. You'll see I have two result sets, and both of those return the exact same thing in different orders. So now I have those top three, and now I got to figure out how to exclude those from my result set. So I'm going to create another query, and let me show you this query that I wrote. I'm populating the same variable with the top three, and then I'm using the summarized columns to display the variable and display the sales amount for each one. See? These are the subcategories, and this is the sales amount. And you can say this is the largest, the next one, and the next one. And if you go take a peek at that visual, mountain bike, road bikes, touring bikes, exact same thing. But I want to remove those from this list. So back over to the query view. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add another query. I'm just taking you on a journey. And so let me copy this other one like a cooking show. What I've done here is I'm saying same variable. I have the top three. I'm going to display the total sales amount. But now I've created a measure. Now, this measure is saying, give me the total sales amount for all the subcategories that's not in the top three lists. And I have to use keep filters so I can keep the context. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete it out so you can see what I'm talking about. So if I run this, you can see it repeats the exact same value for everything, and those three appear. Once I put the keep filters in here, I'm going to wrap that right there, and I'm going to run this. So now you can see when I add the sales without top three measure, there's no values, but you get the values for total sales. And so if I get rid of this measure and run this, there's no more top three. They're completely gone. And now you may be thinking, well, Patrick, how do I use this in a measure? Don't fret. Let's add another query. I love this query view because I can take baby steps to solve my problems. And now you can see this automatically pops up because I'm defining the measure. Same variable. I'm getting the top three. But what I've done is if you go take a look at this calculate statement, what I've done is I've said, give me this top three. The result of this measure is going to be this calculate where I'm applying the exact same filter logic. I'm saying, give me all of those products that's not in this list. Let's get rid of this one and just bring this one back. And so if I run this, it should return the exact same result set. So now I have product subcategory. I am summarizing that column and I'm using this measure. If I bring this measure back in, you'll see they're blank. The values don't exist for those. They're there because I included the top total sales amount because there's no filter or anything applied to this one. Now you may be thinking, well, how do I use this in a visual? Because of my trusty query view, I can add this to the model. Let's go ahead and update my model. Switch over to my view here. I'm going to take this measure, drop it on the table. You can see that it's including everything because they do have values for total sales amount. But if I get rid of total sales amount, now it's excluding the top three. If I want it to be top five, top six, or whatever it is, I just need to adjust the measure and change it from that number to six. I can use a what if parameter if I want to adjust it. I can do lots of different things. All right, what do you think? Any questions, comments? Does this help? I'd love to know. Post it in the comments below. If you want to know more about writing DAX, I'm sure there's probably a video flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.